How's it going, everyone? It is Online here. Welcome back to another video course as always. The Last of Us Part 2 is probably the game I hear about from most people in real life and just overall online asking me questions about when this game's coming out. For good reason, we haven't had an update in 13 months, and that's probably the longest Naughty Dog has gone without giving us an update on a game they've already had announced before. You know, usually you have like the staples like the Game Awards, PSX, or E3 that you get this information, and well, as you guys seen in the past year, Sony's marketing and Sony's way of releasing information is a lot more spontaneous and yeah, out of nowhere than rather these, you know, normal information drops. So I kind of figured I'd take today to go over The Last of Us Part 2 and just talk about what I think is next for information to be released in this title. Just kind of go over all the information we know at this current time, because I know a lot of people are really thirsty for, you know, every single bit of news that we can get. So this is kind of the video that's going to wrap this all together, give some predictions, as well as just go over some rumors and stuff, so. When are we going to hear about The Last of Us Part 2 next? Now, in order to do this, you know, a lot of times I go to the past in terms of when we've heard about titles, but really you can't really do that for the current situation. I mean, as I said, yeah, you don't really have a convention or a specific, you know, venue or convention that Naughty Dog could pop up in or Sony would allow them to, you know, showcase this next, you know, kind of information for this game. So I guess to talk about the past of what we've known about The Last of Us Part 2, you know, the game was originally revealed in, December of 2016. Yeah, about 6 months after Uncharted 4 was, you know, released, we got the full, you know, teaser trailer at PSX. That was like December 2016. Then roughly maybe 10, 11 months later, we got the PGW trailer, kind of teasing the cult, as well as some new characters. And then about, I believe, 7 months or so, 7-8 months, we got the E3 2018 gameplay, you know, reveal, which, you know, has arguably been like the best reveal part so far because we actually got to see gameplay for it. And ever since then, it's now been about 13 months, which is kind of crazy if you ask me, that we haven't had any information. I mean, it's kind of also just goes with the territory because nowadays games take so long to develop in terms of, you know, development time, and development cycles are longer than they've ever been before. So yeah, of course, those kind of factors, as well as just Sony not really having just a lot of games left to really showcase for the PS4 before the arguably like inevitable PS5 next year. You know, we're already getting those kind of teases and stuff, so this is kind of them just trying to like get every single drip of water they can out of, like, you know, what's barely left here. And yeah, obviously things are changing. So where does that leave The Last of Us Part 2? Right now, honestly, if you ask me, I believe we're due for a reveal any week now. Honestly, if you'd have to ask me when, like, we'll actually officially probably get something, like, where I'm having my gut feeling lie towards, I'm gonna put my bet probably towards near the end of August. Now, the reason I did this is because I did some research and I went back to Uncharted 4's kind of, you know, how they kind of revealed information slowly, and when that game was delayed for early 2016, we didn't really get a release date, we just got early 2016, and then later on, like I believe near the end of August, we got a collector's edition, and we got a release date, which is just how Death Stranding got it, so I believe they might do the same thing for The Last of Us. And yeah, well, Uncharted 4 got a release date for March, and it was like near the end of August that we got the information drop. So if the rumors currently are to be believed that, you know, Naughty Dog currently internally is aiming for February 2020, you know, we've heard that from various insiders that that's what it's been for a while now. I'm talking about Jason Schreier, ZHJX, like a lot of notable, incredible, you know, insiders in the industry. I wouldn't, you know, credit them if they weren't, you know, right in the past. I mean, ZHJX has been on fire at least this year in terms of, you know, nailing down state of plays, as well as just Jason Schreier is probably one of the best, you know, journalist around in terms of the gaming industry right now. So yeah, if that's to be believed, internally they're aiming for February 2020 right now, and that would make sense because yeah, you get it out early in the year, Last of Us Part 2 will sell well, incredibly well, definitely in February because not many games drop then, as well as it leaves way for, you know, Sony to be able to focus on PS5 for the rest of the year leading up towards that, and maybe having, you know, Ghost of Tsushima as well. So it all makes sense from that standpoint of view, and if that February 2020, you know, information is to be believed, we're due for any reveal now. If you want to compare it to Death Stranding, which is probably a smart thing to do, we got the official release date and collector's edition information back in May, which was about maybe 6 months before the game's official release date is. So again, that brings us to August. Yeah, So August seems like the month for me. I mean, they could do an end of July thing right here, but yeah, I definitely believe by the end of August we should have an update on The Last of Us Part 2. If you ask me what we'll get, we're probably going to hear about those rumored collector's editions. You know, there's four, I didn't mention this in a video yet, but I guess I'll just mention it here. There was some rumored, you know, special editions for The Last of Us Part 2 that were kind of leaked, I believe. Again, we don't know if this is for sure, but some of them have weird names that are kind of just like, why wouldn't this be true? So yeah, Last of Us Part 2, February 2020, Standard Edition, which of course is the base $60 retail, Special Edition, which I'm guessing is probably going to be like an edition that's maybe $10 or $20 more, a Collector's Edition, which is probably like the main staple, like $120, and then there's an Ellie Edition, which I kind of find funny because Ellie, you know, Ellie Limited Edition, that's just kind of a funny play on words there. So yeah, Ellie Edition will probably be the most expensive edition out of the four. If you ask me what I'm going to get, probably the Ellie edition. Just, I didn't get the survival edition for The Last of Us, you know, originally in 2013, and that was kind of one of my biggest mistakes. Again, Last of Us is one of those games that actually got me into gaming besides just Naughty Dog titles, and just, yeah, so I'm not gonna make that mistake again. I'm definitely gonna get Ellie edition and just can't wait for that game. So that's kind of all the information we're rolling with right now. Yeah, I just definitely want more to work with. I mean, even as a content creator, we just only have those couple reveals to use for thumbnails. Like, yeah, we only have these, you know, images that we can use, and just, yeah, I just want more stuff out there. And just, in a way, as a fan, I don't want to know more about this game. Like, I don't want to see Joel again until I get to play this game for myself and just have that, all that information just blow over my head, like, in one night or a couple, you know, couple days playing this game, as they always are when these games launch, you beat them within a couple days. So, you know, in a way, I want to save it for that, but I know they're going to do another story trailer. We're probably going to get a bigger, you know, focus on what this whole adventure will be. And probably, like Death Stranding, that's what The Last of Us Part 2 will get. I'm guessing it's going to be a standalone reveal that PlayStation might tease a, you know, a day or two beforehand, or just drop all of a sudden, where we're going to get a collector's edition, we're going to get a story trailer, and of course, we're going to get a release date to finally, you know, confirm when we're going to be able to play this, you know, most anticipated title. And, you know, Naughty Dog's taking their time. This is the sequel to one of the biggest, you know, games of all time for a lot of people. Me included, I'd definitely put it in my top five. The Last of Us in 2013 was a special experience. And of course, you just want them to take their time. So yes, it's been a long journey. I know it's kind of been hard that we haven't had any information now, but yeah, given what I've been able to look up and just kind of have my overall gut feeling, I feel like we're due for something next month. So yeah, pretty exciting stuff there. Just, yeah, of course, I'm definitely going to cover it, obviously, when it comes out, so make sure to hit that subscribe button, and just ultimately, whenever we get any information, or, yeah, I've made half a dozen videos on The Last of Us Part 2 this year alone, and we haven't even gotten any information. It's just, that's why I'm so looking forward to this game. Just, yeah, make sure to hit the subscribe button to keep up to date for all these Last of Us Part 2 updates, and like the video if you enjoyed this one. I will say, tomorrow, I'm going to be uploading my Marvel Ultimate Alliance 3 review. I played that over the weekend on the Nintendo Switch, and, yeah, I'm liking the game a lot, and I'm going to do a review tomorrow. So yeah, keep a lookout on for that. Make sure to follow me on Twitter, and as well, I'm also aiming to have a PlayStation VR video and kind of like my favorite titles on PlayStation VR to hopefully come out later this week. I'm talking about maybe like within a day or two after the, you know, Marvel Ultimate Alliance 3 video. So we have some pretty cool videos here on the horizon for the channel, and yeah, that's what's looking for this week. And yeah, I also uploaded just recently on our podcast, Gaming at its Core. We just had our 30th podcast go up, and yeah, we talked kind of about our most anticipated games for fall 2019, as well as kind of give some predictions for the end of this generation and how we see, you know, Sony kind of transitioning into PS5 and what's kind of next for when they talk about stuff. So some pretty cool stuff coming out on the channel and some stuff we just uploaded. So yeah, I'll make sure to leave a link to all that in the description below. And of course, subscribe for updates on, you know, the future videos for the channel. So yeah, again, I've been Online. Make sure to enjoy the rest of your day, everyone. Make sure to like the video if you enjoyed it, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care, everyone.